Through the next, I worked for many years as a fisheries counselor at the Norwegian embassy in Moscow, but yes, we got to Russia. You are now working as an assessor at the Norwegian Forest Force.
Yes, thank you very much. And, good morning. I know that there's a possibility of having an exam for the second half of the meeting. That's about perfect for my perspective. I have a quite big meeting. One of the things that we work with in particular at the business school is international trade and market access. So why is this important? Because this is what they thought. This is where we generate the economy of the region. The whole world is very rich of natural resources. Fisheries, oil and gas, minerals, energy, hydroelectric energy, so on and so on. One of the things that we have been taking quite a big benefit is the trade in Norway and Russia. And this is not by coincidence, because we have always trade, I would like to say, in Russia. From the 16th, 17th century, there was an extensive trade in Norway. Today, the trade in the Norway from August 2014, we also had a substantial trade between Norway and Russia. Very well balanced, although we exported seafood mainly, and Russia exported other merchandise to Norway. The puzzling thing is that through all the experience, we have experienced market access challenges. There has been formal regulations for trade that has hampered, reduced trade possibilities. So we set up a project, research project that started last year. The short form is RUS food. The long is covering the Russian food sector and handling with institutional transformation, mission state, and so on. The project is funded by this community, not very much like, but the Norwegian Research Council, they have a special program. during the Soviet period, Russia developed a very strong food industry based on agriculture and fisheries. And to a very large extent, Russia was quite self-sufficient with food in this period. One of the motives was, aside from being self-sufficient, they also wanted to be independent of the West. And actually, also Russia actually exported quite a lot of food to the West. Grain, which is still an important export commodity. So, one of the sectors that is my experience is the fishing industry. Has been one of the important industries for this self-sufficiency. After the Soviet Union collapsed, there was this dramatic change of the orientation of this industry. They changed focus from supplying the market to a very large extent to export the most valuable products that they catch and process. The agricultural sector is different. They export grain, but many of them